Well, yeah, my RTHD family. How's everybody doing out there? Merry 6 months to Christmas. That's right. Today is Thursday, June 25th, 2020, and it is 6 months until Christmas. Better get that shopping started, huh? This is Road to Happy Destiny with Coach Bear, RTHD. I am Coach Glenn the Bear, and welcome to Season 5, Episode 6 of this fine program. It's our 86th episode of RTHD, and I'm very excited about that. We are in the season where we're doing the quality question, or Q squared, and we got a good one again today, so I'm very excited about it. So go ahead and break out your handy-dandy Into Action notebook so that we can dive into action. Grab your writing utensil for your writing purposes, and let's open up to a brand spanking new page in your handy-dandy notebook, and let's get ready to jot down some thoughts, if you will. I know I will. Well, I already have. So here we go. Today's question is really a carryover from yesterday. This question comes to us from my aunt slash cousin Joy yet again. It's part two of Joy, aka Pie's question, and it's a good one. I really, really like it a lot. Hope you do as well. And of course, we're going to jot down what we are grateful for today also in our handy dandy notebooks. So, are you guys ready? Are y'all ready to get to the Q squared, the quality question? I know I am. Are we riding? Well, I'm with ya, homie. All right, giddy up. Here we go. Our Q squared for today. What has been the biggest awareness that gave you an aha moment in this work? And I'm assuming this work meaning hosting RTHD, although it's not work. I don't get paid for it. But it's a tool, obviously, that I use for myself to help me in my journey along this path to a happy destiny. So, what kind of awareness, what kind of aha moments have I had over these 86 episodes, number 86 being today? Actually, there's been a lot. There has been a lot. But first and foremost, the most important thing, as I've mentioned a number of times, is me doing this show for myself. This show, this program has constantly served as an aha awareness for me that I remind myself of each and every day. You know, during these 86, 87 days that I've been doing this program, and for the couple few weeks prior to starting this program, I have been working on myself. And during this process, I have reminded myself daily of some sort of thing that I need to keep in here and in here that I need to utilize at some point each and every day in order to allow me the opportunity to be on the road to happy destiny. So that's one thing there. There have been times that, in addition to the daily awareness, where obviously I've had a few bad days during this process. Everything's not all upbeat and everything's not all hunky-dory and all that kind of good stuff. So what the program has allowed me to do is keep all these tools, these thoughts, these ideas, these inspirational messages, these thoughts, these readings that I've shared over the course of these seasons of the program with you all they have allowed me to be aware and utilize these things. So some of the rougher days I've had, I have stopped and said, okay, if I were talking on the program right now and someone threw this situation at me, what would I advise them to do? And I would say, I know exactly what I advise them to do. So I'd say perfect. Then advise yourself. And I'd actually go look in the mirror and give myself some of these ideas that we talk about here on RTHD, Road to Happy Destiny with Coach Bear. And, you know, it's been like, aha, yeah, this really, really does help me. I hope that it helps others, and I hope that others have benefited from the things that we have discussed throughout these episodes. So, but really, 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 I mentioned this once before, and I'm going to mention it again, because really the biggest aha moment for me came episodes and episodes ago, where a friend of mine called out of the blue, and she was struggling, and she asked if we could get together so she could talk. And I said, yeah, absolutely, whatever you need. And I remember we got together and we were talking and talking, and I don't know, I after a little bit of the conversation, we it came to a natural taking a break point. And I said, what made you think of me? And she said, I've been watching your show. And that was probably the biggest aha moment I had in doing this type of work, is that there are people watching. There are people that make great comments on Facebook about episodes that we film, that I film. And there are people that get something from the program. There are people that look forward to seeing the show each and every day when I don't get the show up till later, or I haven't gotten the show up till the next day. People have asked, where's the show? Where's the show? So that's been a gigantic aha moment, that people are looking forward to watching the program. And that benefits me, because I know I look forward to doing the program. I can't believe just the other day, I didn't want to force out an episode. I really didn't. It was the first day that in all these weeks, months, whatever it's been, where I said, you know, I just don't feel like doing an episode today. And I said, I'm going to give myself permission to take the day off. Now, of course, my mind wants me to get caught up and do a second show yesterday, which I didn't do, or a second show today, which I may or may not do. Point being is that all these things that I've just discussed have been aha moments for me about doing this program. So let me read the question real quick one more time and see if there's anything that I left out. So from Joy, aka Pi, what has been the biggest awareness that gave you an aha moment in this work? Okay, and you know, the bottom line is the things that I mentioned, that's all wrapped up into one bin aha type of moments for me. But again, that one time when that person called and said, you know, I need to talk, and she said, you know, I've been watching your show and you seem like you know, you'd be a good person to talk to about this. And I don't know if I was helpful or not, I was very humbled and very flattered that person thought of me. So anyway, Joy, thank you so much for the question. Hey, folks out there, I need questions. That's it. I don't have any more questions to load up into for an episode this afternoon or tomorrow's show. So I need you to send me some questions, either email them or text them to me or Facebook message me or just make a comment on after a show, you know, a question that you'd like to hear about on RTHD. So now let's get to our gratitude portion. What are you grateful for today? Let me share with you what I am grateful for today. Over the past couple of days, I have had the opportunity to start paying some bills. I'm in a position right now where I can start paying some bills. And as much as that sounds like something I shouldn't be grateful for, I am very grateful for it. I cannot tell you the relief that I have felt over the last couple of days of being able to start getting caught up with some of my bills and have the opportunity to be able to pay them. You know, I get to pay my bills. And so, you know, that's that have to versus get to situation. And I'm in a position where I can right now, and I'm not all caught up, but you know, hey, taking it one day at a time, everything's a work in progress. And, you know, I believe that, you know, something positive is going to come out of this whole situation for me and for many others. And I just got to live one day at a time and keep the faith that you know, something is out there for me. And so I'm just grateful that I have the opportunity to pay a couple of bills over the last couple of days, and hopefully we'll be, you know, that will continue here in the near and upcoming future. So that's what I'm grateful for today. It seems like a strange thing to be grateful for, but I actually am. So what are you grateful for today? And you know, hey, I'm just excited that I'm back in the mix here with RTHD once again. Merry 6 months to Christmas to each and every one of you out there. Have a wonderful and delightful day on this fine Thursday, this throwback Thursday, this thirsty Thursday. And I'll see y'all tomorrow. Take care now. Peace.